Hey everybody, I'm Jen, sometimes known as Jen of Doom. I'm a front-end developer out of Catalyst here in Wellington and around the place. This is actually my fifth talk at a security conference, despite the fact I'm a front-end developer. Partially it's friends that I have, and partially I do think that security is pretty fundamental to a lot of developer workflows, and we need to be caring more about all of this stuff. So I'm here today to talk to you about giving better feedback to your users about passwords. I'm going to start with a fairly contentious statement. Passwords are fundamentally broken. Why do I say this? Well, hopefully all of you in the same room have some of the same feelings. If we look at data about the most common passwords, we get back stuff like this, which is pretty awful. 1234 shows up 3 times in that list. If I were to go to the full top 10, which I couldn't fit in the slide, it shows up a bunch of times more. I'm not quite sure how football managed to sneak in at the end there. This is data from 2016, and there are a few different organizations that try and pull together this data from various breaches, but it all looks pretty similar, even if the numbering changes slightly. You look at this, and it's easy to say, those users, they're making really rubbish passwords. And as devs or InfoSec folks, we know better. We use password managers, so we don't end up using the same password everywhere. We follow XKCE's advice about using passphrases. We enable two-factor authentication. Maybe we even use a physical token. Our non-technical users, they don't know this yet. And in the absence of external guidance, we really can't blame them for not knowing. And nor would blame actually help to fix anything. That list that I showed you before, that data, if you look back over the years, we've been bleating about all of this stuff as a security industry for years and years. And does the top most vulnerable passwords list change? No, it does not. If we want things to be more secure, unfortunately, we have to enforce those standards ourselves. And one of the ways in which sites are so insecure is that we're just not validating passwords correctly. It's easy to look at that list and say, those are really weak passwords. The flip side of that is really weak validation. In fact, as an industry, we've made a systematic set of perverse incentives that make it more likely for users to create bad passwords. For starters, password and username is in a million different sites. Is it any wonder that absent a password manager that people would reuse passwords just to, so that they can remember all of this stuff? We give bad advice. We say, use a capital letter and a number. And we don't really mention anything about length. And that really doesn't help. We forbid arbitrary things, and rules differ from site to site. So you end up in this punishing game where you put one thing in and that doesn't quite meet the requirements, and you have to keep on changing it, and now it's something you can't remember. Our minimum length requirements are often outdated. Hardware password crackers can blow through a 6-letter password brute force in very, very little time. Overall, we fail to provide good advice. Fortunately, we can do something about it. So today I'm going to be talking specifically about one library called ZXCVBN. This has been around since 2012. It was created by an engineer at Dropbox. It's open source, so it's written in JavaScript. Well, okay, CoffeeScript actually. Kind of the same thing. But there are many ports to different languages, so as well as using it on the front end, you can also use it on the back end. That's the link to their repository. And I'm actually going to show you practically how you would go about using this. So, we have our wonderful page that we'll get to in a second. But first of all, I want to show you, assuming I can find my cursor, I want to show you ZXCVBN's test page. ZXCVBN obviously is the bottom row of keyboard characters because sequences of keyboard characters like we saw with 1234 are very common. This text box is hooked up to the ZXCVBN library, and as we type into it, it's going to provide us feedback about the given password that we've got in the box. You can see here that hello, with threes and zeros, a bit of good old leet speak, can be cracked on an unthrottled online attack, which is to say if you have no rate limiting on your site, in about 33 seconds. And actually, probably that's going to be in a rainbow table, a dictionary attack somewhere, to be perfectly honest with you. The thing I like about ZXCVBN, as well as it giving us these kind of statistics about actually how fast something could be broken, is it's also giving us this warning. And these are nice human-readable warnings that we can actually provide directly to our user. This is similar to a commonly used password. And we can also make suggestions, add another word or two. And predictable substitutions like at instead of a don't help very much. Hopefully that is understandable advice that people can take away and act on. And gradually, we're guiding our users towards creating something. It's really hard to type in a room full of people, by the way. Hopefully we're guiding our users towards creating more passphrases, whether they have spaces in them or not, that start to get up to the realm of centuries to be able to crack it. These bottom two stats are if you are using an offline attack, so that you've just got a database and of passwords and you're iterating through those locally rather than having to go over the web. Right. So, the one other thing that I should point out in this data that we get back is this score. The score for this password is 4 out of 4. For high, it is 0 out of 4. And this score corresponds very nicely with a UI thing you will have seen on many websites when you're creating an account, which is the password strength meter. So we can use this score in order to display a bar of relative strength of our password. Let's see that in action. So here's my secret treehouse website. Over here on the side of the screen, we've got just our regular web developer tools, because in my JavaScript code, just for the purposes of this demo, I have put a console.log statement, which is going to show me what we're typing into the password box, so you can sort of see interactively what's happening. I obviously don't recommend console logging passwords in production. Right, so we've got fairly typical fields in this form. There is a tiny, tiny smidge of validation on this form, mostly because I'm a front-end developer and I didn't want to totally half-ass this demo. It's only quarterly half-assed, if that's a thing. I think it's a thing. So this create account button is actually disabled until we've filled out all of the fields. So I'm going to put in my username. I'm going to put in good old test@example.com. And we're going to pop in our password. So all of the styling that I'm adding here is just stuff I've done myself. So ZXCVBN is just literally a command that you run. It doesn't give you any CSS styling out of the box, but that's probably appropriate. You probably want to make the styling fit your site. Okay, so we're going to go with test, and you can see in my console, we're logging that as we go along. You can see that we're getting back these suggestions, and we're also getting back a warning. This is a top 100 common password, sad but true. And we've got these four segments of bar along the bottom here, which are our strength meter, which currently test is such a weak password that that is doing basically nothing. Let's try something a little bit harder. Hello B-sides. So hello B-sides is actually sufficiently complex that we're getting up to 3 out of 4. Let's try hello treehouse. Oops, might help if I typed it correctly. I guess that's the other thing about the console log. I can see if I'm typing my password right. Okay, so again, that's pretty good. And as we try other things like sequences of keys, so let's try 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. That's a top 10 common password. ASDFG is a very common password. ZXCVBN. Oh, straight rows of keys are easy to guess. But it does reward us when we start doing things like mixing up sequences of keys into something that's more random. So it's almost working like a reverse password cracker. It's looking at what things would typically be in passwords using intelligent data and working backwards from there. So it's pretty good. Let's have a quick look at the code. So this is my index.html page. I'm just using the Bootstrap framework for this. Again, like I say, it comes with nothing. You can do whatever you like. We've got our password field. It's got a label. It's got the input. It's got this little bit of extra markup for the strength bar. There's probably a cleverer way I could have done that, but it does the job. And we've got our alerts down the bottom that we're going to inject our text into. So far, so straightforward. I have got this ARIA described by in there just so that assistive technologies can associate that warning text with the input. In our JavaScript file, I've gone for lo-fi here, and we're using good old jQuery. But again, you could integrate this with whatever framework you like. And we've got here a very simple function that's looking for key up events. So here's where we're actually calling ZXTVBN. It's really, really straightforward to call, very easy. We pass in the password, and we're also passing in some data about the user and about our site. This is an optional array that we can provide so that we can penalize things that look like they might be guessing. Here's my demo purses only console log. And then the rest is basically slicing up the text and injecting it into those fields. Pretty straightforward. The final thing is that I'm just using a simple data attribute to indicate the strength of the password. That's that score value, 0 to 5. And some very, very simple CSS just to display the different colors there. So, pretty easy to use. I only heard about this library this year. Sadly, I don't get to actually do many password sign-up fields nowadays because I'm usually integrating with Realme. Boo hiss. If I was to do another password sign-up field now, I would definitely be integrating this technology. Furthermore, I would be ensuring that I was using a similar library. Like I say, it is ported to many different platforms on the back end so that our logic matches, because there's nothing more frustrating than having a password accepted somewhere and rejected somewhere else. We want to penalize those username or user email specific fragments, and we as site owners have a responsibility to make sure that we are not accepting password or 1234 as a password. Thank you very much.